Hi, I'm Chris Kovac. I'm your Volvo sales representative, national account sales representative.
And with Ryan Gressens, I'm the service representative for national accounts. And together with a team that supports Knight Transportation.
I sell them, he fixes them, is the easy way to remember it. Would like to start off by at the front of the truck, talking about some features that are built into the truck to protect the driver, safety features to protect you, the driver. Volvo's always been a company focused on safety. Safety's in our DNA, whether it be the car division or the truck division, but Volvo's always been synonymous with safety. I want to start to talk about the Volvo Active Driver Assist system, which is your collision mitigation system. We use the combination of a radar, which is here, and a camera up there. What it does is eliminates false positives on a large scale, because the radar picks up the metallic object, and the camera then validates that it is something it needs to initiate the collision mitigation for. No system is 1,000% perfect, but with the combination of radar and camera, you do eliminate a lot of false positives. We have LED headlights in the front. The brighter, give you better visibility at night. There is a fan inside the LED headlights that circulates air to eliminate the lights freezing over. We'll pop the hood here for a second. If you notice it, and if you ever have noticed, Volvo has splayed front frame rails, which means they go out in a Y shape. The purpose of that is, in the event of an accident, a frontal collision, that engine is going to drop down and behind underneath the cab so it doesn't protrude into the cab and potentially cause injury during a crash. So those frame rails give enough room for the engine to drop straight down and back. There's some videos online you can see of that happening. It's pretty cool stuff. So,
and just a couple quick things on the pre-trip, just some fluid levels. You have your power steering reservoir here. Check your engine oil right here. On top is your coolant tank. You can look at on the other side. You can go over the other side and see the levels of it. There's a min and max line in the tank. You want to be in between those two lines. It's your fuel filter housing. When it gets up to the orange line is when the filter is full. It's a good visual check. And then your air filter gauge here. A reminder, if it's in the red, it's time to have the shop take a look at it for you. And those are some of these quick pre-trip items underneath the hood for the visuals for the driver.
As we go around back to the front of the cab, we'll touch another pre-trip item. But before I get in the cab, I want to talk about the cab itself. We're the only North American manufacturer that uses 100% steel for our cabs. It's high-grade Swedish steel as well. Basically, it creates a steel safety cage around the driver. We pass the Swedish impact test, which is to drop a 1,500-pound weight into the A-pillar, a 1,500-pound weight to the back of the truck, and the doors still have to open with less than 10 pounds of pressure. So with those type of impacts, you have to still be able to open the door. One trick I always like to say, you know, if you Volvo cabs are tight, and if you just push the door, you get that. Easiest way is put your palm on the lock here, and it'll shut every time. So just, that's more just a little trick of, but the reason that the is because of the tightness of the cab and the makeup of the cab doesn't allow the air to escape. Okay, we've talked about steel safety cage and pre-trip inspections. So you can reach this button from the ground. This will initiate a light check for your pre-trip inspection. So if I push it, you'll see the green light illuminates and your key has to be on to do this. In the dash, you see where it says exterior lights activated. This will allow you, it's flashing all the lights around the truck in sequence, so you can get out of the truck and check your lights without having any help to have to put the brake on or anything else to test the lights. This is your driver information display. You can access a lot of the truck's functions in here. You can access the pre-trip inspection from here if you don't use the button, but there's also a switch test and an air brake leak down test to assist you in your pre-trip. From a safety perspective, as I said before, you know, Volvo's synonymous with safety. We focused a lot on the driver for many years, decades in fact. So the steering column is energy absorbent. So in the event of an accident, it's gonna push down and absorb energy. We're the only North American manufacturer standard with the airbag for the driver. There's an airbag in here. These panels are energy absorbent as well, so protect your knees and legs in the event of a crash. The windshield is roped in. So in the event of a crash, it's easy to kick that windshield out and create another point of exit for you. From a safety perspective, we have an LED light that's going to flash on the windshield. When the VAT alerts, there's three levels of alerts. You probably get noise and warnings initially, and then it goes into some slowdown or braking and initiation to transmission downshifting. And the last level would be the light all the lights in the dash will go off and let you know that a collision is imminent or coming. And it's applying brakes and down throttling and shifting down to enable you to hopefully help stop the collision. This is your environment. It's all tilted towards you. Of course, radio, push button for the transmission. You do have the premium shifter, so you have some options there. For the driver, these cup holders are movable. You can configure them. There's a button on the bottom. Just push that. And you can put them wherever you want. Plenty of power ports in the truck. You have two USBs on the dash, a 12-volt here. There's another 12-volt down here, okay? And a USB in the stereo if you want to connect to that. Again, all the buttons are, all the driver information, display information can be accessed from here. Your Bluetooth buttons are over here for your phone. The Volvo engine brake is pretty unique. We ought to talk about that for a second. It's five positions. A is the position you're going to want to use most. That's the automatic position. It'll engage itself and disengage itself as needed. The 1, 2, and 3 are your standard, what you're probably used to from years past as a driver. 1 is roughly 30% braking power, 2 is roughly 60%, and 3 would be in that top level braking. The B button is super brake. That's going to engage the compression brakes, your foundation brakes, and down speeding of the transmission to slow the truck down. That's the most aggressive. It's 100% braking power in addition to the downshifting and other things to slow the truck down. Let's go ahead and move into the sleeper and talk about that for a second. In the sleeper cab, a few cool items. There's footwell lighting here and it's blue, so there's less glare if you have to run it, you know, and it doesn't disturb your other driver if you're in a team environment. Talking about power ports again, I missed this one earlier, but it's another 12-volt up here. There's a 12-volt here. And around here you can't see it, but from the top bunk there's a 12-volt as well. Okay. Knight is kind enough to put refrigerators in here. Pretty big refrigerators given the size of the sleeper. Small freezer compartment, works pretty well. Pull out desk. This is the idle smart system, the control pad. They're pre-programmed for the parameters of your fleet. But this is the system that will start and stop the truck before it'll give you enough power to start the truck. It will never let your batteries drain down. It's going to start and charge the batteries before that happens. And it can control your heat. So when the parking heater is on, which this has a parking heater underneath, this will, again, charge the batteries so you don't get into a load shed situation where the heater may work, but the fan is out of batteries or low enough. So that system is we put that on at Fontaine, and it, again, controls the automatic start and stop of the truck. Moving around here, we have airline style shades for the window, for the fold down. You know, none of the old Velcro or snaps that, you know, you lose or what have you. Vent windows, just a simple fold out there. In the back, you can control a lot of functions from this sleeper control panel. It's the better sleeper control panel. You control your bunk heater from here as well. There's a panic button here. If you ever feel you're in an unsafe situation, you push that button and hold it in, and it's going to initiate the city horn continuously until you hit it, much like the button on your car key fob. Two more power ports here. You got two USBs and a 12 volt. I lost count, but it's well over half a dozen power ports through the front and back. Plenty of lighting. We've got it all illuminated here. You got side there. The small lights on both the front and the upper cab will go in different colors if you just continue to push the button, and ample overhead light. These are all LED lights in the cab, so they should be good for many, many hours, way over an incandescent bulb. We integrate the TV mount here, so you have storage behind it if you put a flat panel in here, okay? Simple fold out here is, look at it from many angles. Ample cabinetry on the top here. And also behind, main cabinetry here. And here's your wardrobe cabinet on the other side. So what you can't see, but you may be able to hear and feel in Volvo, Remember I talked about the steel safety cage and 100% Swedish steel? Because the cab is tight, because the cab has wonderful integrity, that's going to contribute to a smoother ride and a quieter ride. Another thing Volvo is known for, safety, smooth, quiet ride, and comfort.